In this video, we will dive into the concepts of properties, links, dependencies, and how to customize them to get the perfect contents for your pop-up. First concept, the properties. Each column becomes a property. We use the title of the column to determine the property name. Properties are useful because they act as attributes of requirements, which you can use in your search queries. For example, this search query can return all requirements related to component A. Since it can be difficult to write a search query when there are white spaces in the property name, we've made it easy. You can click on the property in the pop-up, and it builds the search query for you. If there is no hyperlink on the name of the property, it means it's too complex to search. Second concept, the links or references. You can create a reference to a requirement from any page. References can be noticed because they have the little arrow before the requirement key as opposed to the requirement definitions. Clicking on a reference will lead you to the original page. Scroll to the correct position in the page and highlight the requirement in blue. When you create a reference to a requirement, the pop-up lists all pages with references to this requirement under the See Also section. To create a link, just reuse the same macro, Alt-Shift-R, but type the key of an existing requirement and press Enter, or select the link in the list. You can confirm that you have created a link by checking that the macro contains the keyword link in the editor or that it has the little arrow in view mode. Third concept, when you put those links in a column, it becomes a dependency. In this example, we say that the child FN1 depends on the parent requirement BR1 with the relationship relates. Dependencies are necessary to create the traceability matrix. There are often many types of dependencies, which is why we use the title of the column as the name of the relationship. In Requirement Yogi, every relationship, even with Jira or with properties, has a relationship name, which can be useful to filter dependencies later on. As well, we've learned that every customer has a different workflows, so we don't mandate any specific wording or organization of requirements, and users are free to choose relationship names. One more thing, you can simplify table headings. It happens often that you need to type more information in the heading, and you want to simplify it for the property or dependency. To simplify the name of a property, put the RY property macro in the heading and fill the name field. This RY property macro is very useful. You can also use it to define a property that is not a column if you fill the name and value fields. You can also use it to define a property for all requirements in the whole document. Put it at the beginning of the document and tick Whole Document. You can also use it to ignore an entire column, put it in the heading and tick Ignore for Properties or Ignore for Dependencies. You are now an expert at editing requirements. So how do you query them and create beautiful reports to visualize the state of your project? Check out our next tutorial for the search syntax and the following one about the traceability matrix.